Hello students, welcome to the next session of Engineering Mechanics. This is Professor Vidyasagar Mugi. In this session I will be continuing with the examples of moment of inertia. So what you see in front of you is a irregular shaped object or a lamina, right? So the first step what we follow before we approach the moment of inertia problem is fixing of the reference line. Also let me tell you that whoever is watching this video for the first time, so I have one more part done wherein I have discussed the steps to approach the moment of inertia problem, which you can refer, so it will be easy for you to understand the procedure that I am following in this session. So firstly, when we start the problem, before starting what we do is, first thing is we fix up the reference axis. So the reference axis is fixed such that the whole object falls in the first quadrant. Now what you see here is, if I see this object as an individual, the base is given as 24 mm, thickness of that is 4 mm. This is called as a web portion and it is 4 mm and height is 12 mm. Similarly, this is a semicircle here whose radius is what? 6 mm. So what will be the diameter? It will be 12. So in order to find out the moment of inertia, so what is the question is, find the polar radius of gyration. So what is the meaning of polar radius of gyration? So polar radius of gyration, it is nothing but it is KZZ. So KZZ is unknown. So that is polar moment of inertia means it is moment of inertia, or polar radius of gyration means radius of gyration about Z axis. So to get the value of KZZ, first I should know is what is value of IZZ. Now to know what is value of IZZ, I should calculate what? I should calculate what is value of IXX and IYY. Because using perpendicular axis theorem, I can find out what is IZZ. If I know what is IZZ, I can calculate what is KZZ. Okay, so firstly, starting with the first step, that is, we have fixed up the reference axis. So about reference axis parallel to XX, I'll call this as AA, and parallel to y axis I'll call this as BB. Second step what we do is we divide the figure into known geometrical shapes. Now this known geometrical shapes, the division of known geometrical shapes is required because to locate the centroid of the object. So location of centroid is required because we are going to find out moment of inertia of the object about the centroidal axis. Now when I divide this given figure into the known geometrical shapes, so I'll mark this as first element, I'll mark this as second element, and this as third element. Now which are those elements here? So this is first, this is second, and this is third. Now the first element is a semicircular object. When it is separated from this, it is a semicircle. This is a rectangle and this is a rectangle. Now if you see this figure, semicircle is not touching the reference axis. The same way I'll represent it here. Now the semicircle is taken out, it has its own centroid that is given as G1. So I'll mark the distance of this centroid with respect to the reference axis. So this is X1 and this is Y1. So what is the value of X1 now? X1 is nothing but this total is 24. So what is this total distance? So radius is 6, means the diameter is 12. So 24 minus 12. So I should know what is this distance. Or if I see here, I should know what is this distance. So this distance is nothing but it is 24. 24 minus 12 is how much? 12 divided by 2. This is 6 mm. So this distance is 6 mm. Now what is x1? It is from here to here, it is 6. 6 plus what is this total length? It is 12. So 6 plus 12 by 2, it is symmetric about y axis, so it is directly 6 plus 6. So 6 plus 12 divided by 2, so it is nothing but it is 12 mm. So x1 I got is 12 mm. Similarly, what is y1? So y1 is from this reference axis, from here to the center of this. So from here to the base of this, how much is the distance? From here to here, from here to here, what is the distance? So it is 4 plus 12. So 4 plus 12 is 16. So y1 value is 4 plus 16 plus, what is the formula from here, base, to find the CG of this? It is unsymmetrical about x axis, so it is 4r by 3 pi, 4 into r is 6 divided by 3 pi. So I'll get this answer as, 18.54 mm. So x1, y1 is known. Similarly, I'll calculate x2. What is x2 now? So x2 is 24 is touching the reference axis. 24 minus 4 is what? 24 minus 4 is, so to calculate this distance, how I'll calculate? I'll calculate this distance as 24 minus 4 is 20 divided by 2. So how much I'll get? I'll get this distance as 10. Means this distance is 10 mm. But what is x2? X2 is 10 plus, I want from here to here, center of this to this. So 10 plus, what is base? Base is 4. This width is 4. So 10 plus 4 by 2. How much I'll get? I'll get 12 mm. Right. So then what is y2? Y2 is 4 plus 12 by 2. So 4 plus 12 by 2 is 12 by 2 is 6 plus 4, 10. So 10 mm. 4 plus 12 by 2 is 6 plus 4, 10. Similarly, x3 is, I'll directly solve. This is 24 total divided by 2. 24 by 2 is 12 mm. What is y3? Y3 is total is 4 divided by 2. So is 2 mm. So this is calculated. So these are the centroidal distance of individual object. And on the same hand, I should calculate what is IGXX or IG11 or and IGY1. So what is IGX1 for semicircle? So semicircle, we have a formula derived. So it is about x-axis, it is symmetrical, unsymmetrical. So IGX1 is given by formula 0.11 r raised to 4. And about y-axis, it is symmetrical, so it is given by pi r raised to 4 by 8. So moment of inertia of the semicircle about x-axis is 0.11 r raised to 4, and about y-axis is pi r raised to 4 by 8. So calculate these values. So calculating these values, I get, so this as 142.56 mm raised to 4, and this is pi into r is 6 raised to 4 divided by 8. So I get this as 508.93 mm raised to 4. Similarly, I need to calculate what is value of IG X2 and what is IG Y2. So this might not be a problem because it is a rectangular section. So directly I'll calculate, it is BDQ by 12, DBQ by 12. So in the last video, I have told you how to consider, which width to consider first here in this case, and which dimension to consider here first in this case. So I'm calculating about X axis. So first width I'm going to consider, first dimension that I'm going to consider is parallel to X axis, that is 4 into 12 cube divided by 12. So we'll get this as 576 mm raised to 4, and this one is 12 into 4 cube divided by 12. So we'll get this as 64 mm raised to 4. Similarly, I'll calculate what is IG X3 and what is IG Y3. So IG X3 is 24 into 4 cube divided by 12. So I'll get this as 128 mm raised to 4, and this one is 4 into 24 cube divided by 12. So I'll get this as 4608 mm raised to 4. So let me cross verify once. Yeah, it is correct. So once I get all these values, x1, y1, ig, x1, ig, y1, similarly these things, what is the next step? It is entering in the table. So what is the first component? So first component is semicircle. Second component is rectangle. And third component is also a rectangle. So semicircle we have marked as 1, rectangle as 2, and this rectangle as 3. Area of semicircle is what? Pi into r square by 2. pi r square by 2 is pi into 6 square, pi into 6 square divided by 2. So I get this area as 56.54 mm square. Similarly, rectangle, it is 12 into 4. This is 4 into 12 is 48, and this is 24 into 4 is 96. Is 96. After doing this, immediately solve the make the totals. So this is summation A. So summation A is 56.54 plus 48 plus 96. So get this answer as 200.54 mm square. Now x distance, x1, y1, x1, x2 and x3 distance we have calculated, and we have got them as 12, 12 and 12. What is y1 distance? y1 distance is 18.54 and y2 distance is, we have calculated here, it is 10 and y3 is 2. So y2 distance is 10 and y3 distance is 2. Now what is the next step? Multiply these values here. So 56.54 into 12 is 678.48. Likewise, multiply 56.54 into 18.54. We'll get this A into Y1. Okay, so as I multiplied A into Y, likewise what I'll do is I'll multiply all these values. So multiplying, I'll get these things. So once we are done with finding out these values, what the next thing what we do is I'll take summation A into X, which is doing summation A into X, A into Y, A into X square, A into Y square, summation IGX and IG YY, I'll get these values. Once I obtain these values, what he has asked to find out? He has asked to find out IZZ. But to find IZZ, first what I require? I require IXX and IYY. So to get IXX, what the step that we have to follow here is using parallel axis theorem. Using parallel axis theorem, I know that we have marked those reference axes as AA, so I'll take this as IAA is what? It is summation of IGXX plus summation AY square. To get value of AA, that is this reference axis AA, I should multiply what values? I should multiply summation IGX plus A Y square. So I'll get this value as summation IGX is 328.16 plus summation AY square is 24,618.55. So adding this, I'll get 328.16 plus 24,618.55. So I'll get this as 24.94 into 10 to the power 3 mm raised to 4. So this is what? This is moment of inertia about IAA. But what I want? I want moment of inertia about IXX. So once I have got moment of inertia about reference axis AA, so I'll go backward direction, that is to find out moment of inertia about the reference axis, this symmetrical axis XX. So what I'll do is I should go by what distance? I should go back by distance of y bar. Now how will you calculate y bar? So y bar is calculated as, I'll not go much into this because we have done on centroid. So y bar is what? Summation A into X by summation A. So getting that X bar, what you'll get? You'll get X bar as 12 mm. Similarly do for y bar, what you'll get? It is summation A into Y by summation A. So summation A into Y is 1720.25 divided by area is 200.54. So get this as 8.57 mm. So value of y bar is 8.57 mm. Now using parallel axis theorem again, using parallel axis theorem, I know that parallel axis theorem states that IAA is equal to what? Moment of inertia about symmetrical axis IXX plus total area into y bar square. Then IAA, I know it is 24.94 into 10 to the power 3. This is equal to what? Ixx is unknown plus what is total area? Total area is 200.54 into what is y bar value? It is 8.57 whole square. So I'll get what is Ixx. Ixx is 24.94 into 10 to the power 3 minus 200 into 8.57 square. 200.54 into 8.57 square, you will get this as 14.73 into 10 to the power 3. So value of Ixx is 24.94. So it is 10.21 into 10 to the power 3 mm raised to 4. So this is the value of Ixx. On the same hand, what I'll do is I'll find out what is value of Iyy. So again, using parallaxis theorem. So now I22. So I22 is what? It is or IBB is parallel to what? It is parallel to y axis. So what I'll do is I'll take using reference axis. First, I'll find out what is value of IBB. So IBB is nothing but summation IGYY plus summation A into X square. So summation IGYY is what value? IGYY is 5180.93 plus summation AX square is 28877.76. So I'll get this as 28877.76 plus 5180.93. So I'll get this value as 34.05 into 10 to the power 3 mm raised to 4. So this is IBB. Now again, to get what is IYY, what I should do? I should go by distance of x bar. So parallaxis theorem, again I'll make use of this. Then using parallaxis theorem, I know that IBB is given by IYY plus AX bar square. Now what is unknown? IYY is unknown. So IBB minus AX bar square. So IBB is 34.05 into 10 to the power 3 minus 200.54 into 12 square. So 200.54 into 12 square, you'll get, okay, so you'll get one answer. So 34.05 into 10 to the power 3 minus answer, you'll get the value of IYY as 5.17 into 10 to the power 3 mm raised to 4. So this is value of IYY. So once you get what is value of IXX and IYY, I'll write here. So IXX is equal to what? So it is 10.21 into 10 to the power 3 mm raised to 4, and IYY is 5.17 into 10 to the power 3 mm raised to 4. Now what is to be found out? So the value that is to be found out is IZZ. Now how will you get IZZ? We know that IZZ is equal to what? IXX plus IYY. How did we came to this conclusion? So we came to this conclusion because of perpendicular axis theorem. So perpendicular axis theorem is what? It is nothing but mathematically it is given as moment of inertia about z axis is equal to what? Sum of moment of inertia about x axis and y axis. Now to calculate IZZ, I know that moment of inertia about x axis is what? 10.21 into 10 to the power 3 plus moment of inertia about y is 5.17 into 10 to the power 3. So adding both 10.21 plus 5.17, I'll get moment of inertia about ZZ as 15.38 into 10 to the power 3 mm raised to 4. So this is the actual answer that is needed. So we got what is IZZ. But what is asked in the question? So the question asked is to calculate what is polar moment of inertia. So polar moment of inertia, that is KZZ, is given by under the root IZZ divided by area. So what is IZZ now? So IZZ we calculated, it is 15.38 into 10 to the power 3 divided by area is 200.54. So 15.38 into 10 to the power 3 divided by, so we'll get the value of KZZ as 8.75 mm. So this is called as the polar moment of inertia, polar radius of gyration, and this is called as polar moment of inertia. Hope you understood this problem. So this was all about the moment of inertia of the solid laminas. So in the next session we'll be taking up the problems on finding the moment of inertia of the shaded portion or the cutout laminas. Thank you very much.